In the criminal justice system, holiday-based offenses are considered especially heinous. On Manhegan Island, the dedicated detectives who investigate these vicious felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Special Islanders Unit. These are their stories. It was a typical Thursday night in the office. Not much was happening on island. Got a few calls about missing golf carts and loose dogs. Nothing out of the usual day-to-day agenda I have as Manhegan's finest private eye. By the way, the name's Bond. Sherlock Bond. And I'm the lead detective for Manhegan's Special Islanders Unit. Anyways, I figured I would just have a quiet night in the office, playing Angry Birds on my iPad, while it ran cats and dogs outside. I was just settling in while there was a flash of lightning at the window and a knock at the door. I don't know which one startled me more, but I gained my composure, hid the iPad, and said, "Come in."
Come in.
A lovely old broad walked into my office. It was love at first sight. No, not that kind of love. The way you love your grandmother after she reads you a bedtime story and tucks you in and kisses your forehead.
Hello, Grandma. Ma'am. What can I do for you?
Oh, thank goodness you're here, Detective. I don't know what to do. I hope you can help me.
I, of course, wanted to help her any way I could, but I kept getting distracted by her scent of milk and cookies and that weird mole on the end of her chin.
Yes, mole head. Go ahead.
Well, as you may know, I'm Mrs. Claus.
Mrs. Claus, you say? Yes, heard of you.
Yes, well, I need to report a missing person from the North Pole.
The North Pole, you say? Yes.
Yes, our head elf is missing.
Calm down, ma'am. It's okay. I've never handled a missing persons case before, but I have handled missing cats, dogs, chickens, lobsters, lobster traps, miscellaneous wharf items, golf carts, and pies.
Oh, I feel a little bit better.
But I need to get some information first. Let's see. First of all, you say the elf is missing from the North Pole, but you're on Manhegan. Can you explain?
Yes, well, see, Buddy the Elf, that's his name. He was coming down here to find some recipes because, well, Mr. Claus, he doesn't think my recipes are like they used to be, but that's another story. Anyway, Mr. Claus wanted me to find some new recipes, so Buddy was helping out. So he was going to go all over the world and find me some recipes, and his first stop was here, and I think maybe it's his last stop.
All of this information was very interesting, especially since just last week I remember watching a very intriguing documentary on an elf named Buddy.
Okay, well, I feel like I know this elf character pretty well, and I think we'll have no problem tracking him down. I just need a picture to show him to my team and ask you a few more questions, and then we'll get right down to business.
Oh, thank you. You know, Buddy, he's our head elf at the North Pole, and if we don't find him, Christmas will be ruined.
Don't worry, Grandma Claus. This is a holiday mystery that's sure to end jolly.
Oh, why are we still in black and white? Isn't this 2011?
Oh, sorry, ma'am. I can fix that. We're just trying to create a mood.
Oh.
I can fix that, too.
Okay, alright squad, listen up. We have a serious case on our hands. Probably the biggest that we've ever had on Manhegan.
Bigger than when Barbara Hitchcock couldn't find her hat?
Yes, bigger.
Bigger than when Dougie's tire mysteriously popped off?
Yes, much bigger.
Well, bigger than when the ice palm water was blue?
Yes, bigger than that. Now let me introduce you to Mrs. Claus.
Oh, hello, ma'am. I'm a big fan.
Oh, nice to meet you.
This is our lab technician, Alfred Sputnik. He's also the case psychologist.
So pleased to meet you.
And then that is Nancy, my partner, Nancy Shrew.
Sup.
And then this is our captain, Captain Duck.
Oh, nice to meet you. Oh. glad you're all here to help me find my poor buddy.
This is Buddy the Elf. We know that he has brownish hair, brownish eyes, he's thin, wearing green pointy shoes, and a hat with the jingle bell on it. You can't miss him.
According to Old Lady Claus over there, the last known location for Buddy the Elf was in front of the fish house. That's right. He was going to look for Lisa, something about her world-famous donut recipe.
Donuts. I love donuts.
Ah, those donuts are delicious. The perfect chemical equation of sugar and deep-fried goodness.
Let's hope the donuts weren't the only thing that were deep-fried.
Watch your partner.
Okay, we're here to find out what you know about this man, he's an elf.
Oh yes, Buddy. He was here a couple of days ago. He is so cute. Oh, so Buddy, what time was he here?
He was here, I'd say 9 o'clock, I think it was Tuesday morning.
And what did you talk to Buddy about?
Buddy wanted my donut recipe. And I said, no way, he could not have it. I don't give my donut recipe out to anybody.
Did you tell him what you do if
yes,
you got it?
Yes, I did. I told him I'd sick Choco on him.
Choco wouldn't hurt a fly.
Oh, yeah, I know, but Buddy didn't know that.
All right, Lisa. So do you know where this Buddy went after that?
Buddy, I think, well, he said something about finding somebody else who bakes really well on the island, and I think he went to Angela's house to get her bagel recipe.
Mm. Time to find Angela the bagel maker. Maybe she can help us find a hole in this case.
Well, thank you, Lisa, very much for all of your help.
You are welcome. Do you guys want to come in and have some coffee and donuts, maybe?
No, we're good.
Really?
Yeah, we're on a low-calorie diet.
I can't believe that. What a party poop.
Yeah.
Chaco,
sorry.
It's okay.
Bye, thank you.
Thank you.
Heel.
Okay.
Just go. What, do we call in reinforcements?
Yeah, I figured this could get ugly.
Please, open up!
Very interesting. From my scientific calculations, yes, from the lack of sound waves in the room, I'm guessing that there's no one home.
Dang it. Dead end.
Unless we can figure out where else she could be.
The laundry room.
Excellent. Captain Duck, let's go.
Put your hands up where I can see them.
Oh my, what's going on?
Calm down, Shrew. Just calm down.
How did you guys know I was here?
I'm sorry, Mom. I mean, ma'am. We're just here to ask you a few questions.
Okay, but I'm kind of in the middle of this. I'm doing my laundry.
We're the ones asking the question, ma'am. Have you seen Buddy the Elf?
Yeah. He was here asking if he could have my bagel recipe. And I said sure.
What? You gave Buddy the Elf your bagel recipe of his scientific equation that's so good?
I just told him, he could have it, but if I gave it to him, I was gonna have to stuff him in a lobster trap with all this dirty underwear. And, yeah, so I didn't give it to him.
Wait, you threatened the life of our victim?
Victim? Buddy the Elf is not a victim. He's such a, he's just so... Anyway, he's not a victim. I didn't do anything to him. I told him to go up to the trailing yoke because his blood sugar was low or something and he wanted something sweet. So I told him to go to the U because there's always something sweet up there. So that's what I did. I'm just trying to do my laundry.
Oh, yeah, well, I did see some odd-looking footprints heading in that direction, so I guess we'll go. That's going to be our next stop.
Trailing you, I know where that is. Follow me.
Yes, Captain, let's go.
Well, I sure hope there's something to eat.
Yeah, me too, I'm starving.
Hey, Billy.
Come on, Billy.
can deduct by the fact of all circumstances that it's obviously closed, and Buddy the Elf has not been here.
But just because Buddy the Elf isn't here doesn't mean he has not been here.
I think we should knock down the doors, kick down the doors.
Why? Don't. But we could just open them.
Genius, Captain.
Okay, but just in case, get your weapons ready.
All right, on your cue, Captain.
Go, go, go!
Clear.
Clear.
Clear, but I have found something that proves that Buddy has been here.
What's that, Alfred?
A jingle bell. We should go straight back to the lab and test it.
Let's hope the jingle bell isn't the only thing our little friend has lost.
So Sputnik, what test are you planning to run on the jingle bell?
I got a couple. The first one's going to be the kneecap test. Always important. The next is going to be the SSATs. Yeah, and the last one is going to be EPT test.
Hey guys, look at this. It's a sign for a dance party up at the ball field.
Dance parties. I love dance parties.
Well, Captain, it looks like the dance already happened, but maybe we should go up there to look for clues.
Good idea, Bond. All right, everyone. One, two, three, break!
No, I just found this sombrero. And this tutu. I don't know what they're doing up here.
I know, and all I found is this duck decoy, but I figure I'll bring it back to the captain.
You know what we should do? We should definitely recreate the scene.
Good idea! Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so there's probably some music, right?
You know, right. Yep, and around. Everyone's probably starting to like
move.
Bust a move.
Yeah.
Yep.
So they're all probably having a great time. They must have been shuffling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And Buddy, he probably was breakdancing. He's kind of like that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And probably like a little somersault or something.
Oh, yeah. Hey, what's this?
I don't know. Oh, what is
green,
that?
It's a green shoe.
What kind of loser
wears a green shoe.
A loser who happens to be our elf who happens to be missing. And look, it looks like something fell off.
Like a jingle bell.
Oh, yeah. A genius, dear Shrew, now you're thinking.
Thanks.
Hello, detectives. I've finished my tests on the jingle bell, and there's traces of maple syrup and spaghetti.
That makes sense because Mrs. Claus told us that that's Buddy's favorite meal, spaghetti with maple syrup.
And that means the jingle bell we found inside of the U must be his. Mm-hmm. And here, this green shoe must be his too.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
There's a receipt inside his shoe, guys. It looks like it's from the Black Duck.
What's it for?
It looks like it's $300 of Cocoa Joes and gummy fish.
Well, he must really like his sweets.
Yeah, I think we should head back down to the Black Duck and see if there's any information we can find out there.
Great idea.
And I'll go tell the captain where you guys are heading. I'll also bring this green shoe.
All right.
Well, it looks like all the ducks in this case are not all in a row.
Officer Sherlock and partner.
Hello. We were looking for. Here, let me get a picture. Well, I've got a picture. But he was an elf. He was wearing a lot of green and he was pretty tall. We're wondering if you had seen him lately.
I think. Well, do you know? Does he drink triple shots with soy, whipped cream, little caramel, and different things? Sometimes coconut, sometimes little hazelnut.
Yeah, that sounds like our guy. Did you talk to him at all?
I kind of listened. I had a listen, not a conversation with him. Kind of interesting guy. He's traveled around with Santa, been all over the world. Every place you mention, he knows. He wants to tell you all about. And he also has a family that kind of comes to Monhegan. His parents came before he was even born, actually, so he grew up knowing about it. His first trip here, he really wanted to come. Didn't say where he came from, but he mentioned the North Pole, and he mentioned getting in fights with elves and that kind of thing. And then he talked about maybe someone else in his family had come, and maybe had had an affair with either a stern man or someone who worked at the Monhegan house. I'm kind of unclear about that, but anyway, I think that's the guy. Did I help you out?
Actually, we're wondering where he went.
After out the door?
Yeah.
He didn't ask. Sometimes people say, where's Lobster Cove, or the shipwreck, or yada da da da. Sorry, I can't help you.
Great. So he came down here for nothing.
Well, you know, he drinks.
Well, I'm sorry. I have to excuse my partner. She's a little... But, thank you a lot.
And... I have a picture of him.
Oh, that'd be good. That'd be helpful.
Let me find my... hold on. I'm just finding it here. Because he looked a little, well, I don't want to be weird and rude, but he looked a little unusual, so I took a picture of him. And it is, let me just scroll back here. No, that's the man who actually peed on the side of the building, but so it was after that. There you go.
Yeah, that's our guy. He has one shoe. Yep, that's our guy.
Oh, well, thank you very much, but we have to go.
You're welcome. Time for a beverage?
No.
All right, thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, that was a complete waste of time. What are we going to do now?
Well, before we head back to the station, I think we should check the mail.
Oh, for clues?
No. For Netflix. Dang, no Netflix. Just a stupid package.
Does it say who it's from?
Well, it says, the return address says suspicious individual.
Huh.
I wonder what that means.
Yeah, well, maybe we should just take it back to the station anyway. But this might be just the clue we need for the case. But we better hurry because Christmas is only 2 days away.
Yeah. Wow. Well, here we go. It looks like someone has gone postal.
What's going on?
Well, Captain.
knocked, and we got an envelope in the mail that said suspicious envelope. And then inside the envelope was one single DVD, which said suspicious DVD. So now we're going to watch it.
Yeah. So, everybody watching?
Yep.
Let's play it.
Okay, buddy. Tell me where Mrs. Claus's recipes are now. I'm warning you, buddy. Tell me where the cookies are.
No! No! No!
I want the cookies and the recipes, or else you will see your toys suffer. Mrs. Claus's cookies and all of her recipes dropped at the shipwreck by tomorrow afternoon, or else you may never see your little buddy again.
Well, it looks like Buddy hasn't gone missing by choice. He's been elf-napped. Sputnik, could you see any clues on the video that might help us?
Well, the video was definitely taken in a place that's very unfamiliar to the community. And because the suspect was wearing gloves, I can't do any technological finger tests on the film.
Why don't you test the envelope for fingerprints or any other clues?
Great idea, Captain. I'll let you know if I find anything.
Captain, Detective Shrew and I will narrow down the suspects and see which people could possibly have stolen Buddy. And we'll inform Mrs. Claus and what we find.
All right, let's figure out this case fast. Christmas depends on it.
You're right, Captain. And it looks like Buddy is depending on us.
I can't believe they've kidnapped our little elf Buddy. When do you think it happened?
Well, it probably happened right after he was at the Black Duck, and he's probably been followed since the time he got here. We're estimating that it's been probably 16 hours since they first got him.
I don't think I can make that many cookies in that amount of time.
Don't worry, Granny. We've been narrowing down the suspects list, and we got it down to a mere 8 individuals.
Brown Owl Thompson, Chuck Norris, Tara Heyer, Travis Dow, Billy B., Cookie Monster, and Norma Capolis. Oh, don't forget Oprah.
Oh, do you really think Cookie Monster did it? After all, he's a puppet.
Wait, Cookie Monster's not real?
Close your ears, Captain.
Good point, Mrs. Claus. Cookie Monster is only a puppet. He couldn't have done it. Who else can we narrow down?
Well, let's see. Brownell, he really likes cookies, but he's awfully small. So he probably couldn't have elf-napped Buddy by himself.
And Oprah couldn't have done it. I mean, she has enough money to buy all those cookies.
And I don't think Chuck Norris could have done it. If he wants cookies, he just looks at them and they come right to him.
Okay, we only have 4 suspects. What are their motives?
Well, let's see, Mrs. Claus, are your cookies gluten-free?
Oh, goodness, no.
Well, can't be Norma. She only eats gluten-free food.
Okay, now we have 3. What are their motives?
I think Travis has been on Santa's naughty list quite a few times.
All right, and Tara, she's very nice. However, she's a smart businesswoman. If she got a year's worth of cookies, she could freeze them and sell them at the Carina. She'd make a mint.
What about Billy B?
Hey, guys, I found something. I ran a bunch of tests on the envelope that the ransom came in.
Did you find fingerprints?
No, I found something even better. After breaking down the paper material and dissolving the genetic makeup of the contents, I was able to filtrate 2 chemical substances which left the residue on the envelope. Potato sodium chloride and trithexamine.
Sputnik, in English, please!
Okay, I found the traces of coffee and potato chips on the ransom note.
Billy B! We've got our guy. I think he was on Santa's naughty list.
Go get him, fella.
Okay, squad, this is the biggest bust we've ever had.
This is the only bust we've ever had.
Anyways, I have all the documentation papers right here. Billy B's search warrants and the naughty list. It's quite extensive if I do say so myself.
All right, fellas, get her done.
Put your hands where we can see them. You're under arrest.
I'm innocent, I swear.
Put a sock in it, Humpty Dumpty.
Calm down, Shrew. You're under arrest for elf-napping Buddy the Elf.
Anything you say or do will be held against you in the court of law.
I'm innocent, I swear.
Tell it to the judge, Pringle Breath.
Am I being put on trial?
Yes. In fact, you are. Wait till you see who the prosecuting attorney is.
Yeah. Order in the court. Next case, please. Oh, man, this is going to be a good one. The people against Billy Boynton.
Please state your name for the record, sir.
Willard Boynton.
Well, Willard, where were you on Thursday afternoon between the hours of 1 and 4 p.m.?
Well, let's see. I had to go to Allison's to pick up a painting we needed to frame. And then I went home and practiced my bingo skills. I stopped at Karina and got a cup of coffee, and then I walked to the post office.
Okay, I want to get this straight, so let me make sure I understand this. You say you drove to Allison's to pick up a painting, and then you drove home to practice bingo, and then you drove to Karina to get some coffee, and then you walked to the post office to get your mail.
Yes, that's what I said.
Mr. Boynton, I can produce 50 witnesses right now that say you never walk anywhere.
Ha! That's funny! You're screwed!
In fact, when your truck breaks down, you borrow your brother's truck.
Isn't that badgering the witness? Good point. That's a good point. I want to see you in my chambers, Counselor.
Judge?
Counselor, would you care for a splash of rum?
Well, thank you, Judge. I'd love some. Just a splash, though, please.
Okay, listen, we both want to put this son of a nutcracker away, so make sure that your case is solid in this. Cheers.
Clay. Don't worry, Judge. Don't worry, Judge. This cotton-headed ninny-muggin, he makes me sick. I know just what to do to crack him.
Cheers. How about another? You can't fly on one wing.
Okay. Mr. Boynton, I was recently reminded about Santa's need to fly on Christmas Eve. Did you know that he flies all around the entire world delivering presents to all the good boys and girls?
I knew that.
And did you also know that Buddy the elf that you apparently have never laid hands on, is Santa's first elf and master mechanic for his sleigh? And if we cannot find Buddy, there won't be any Christmas this year. What do you think about that, Mr. Boynton?
Well, I like Christmas.
Do you also know who likes Christmas? Millions of children around the world. Children who will be devastated if there's no Christmas. Children like your own daughters. I believe their names are Mia and Claire.
Oh, Mia and Claire, I'm sorry. I did it. I elf-napped Buddy, and I am so sorry. All I could think about was the cookies. I loved them so much. I couldn't help myself. I ran into him at the Black Duck, and he said, telling me about all his favorite foods. Candy, candy canes, candy corn, and I just felt like we had a soul connection. And then he told me about Mrs. Claus's cookies, and I knew I had to have them.
That's good, Mr. Boynton. You must feel so much better. Now, if you'll just tell us where you're keeping Buddy, we can get you some of Mrs. Claus's cookies.
I've been keeping him at Newt's. He's quite comfortable, and we play cribbage every day. Enough! I've heard enough from this moron! I'm gonna pass sentence. I sentence you to 1 year without potato chips, coffee, or your truck. And that starts right now. And we'll revisit this issue next Christmas to see if you've been naughty or nice. Case closed!
Here's to a fantastic case and the fantastic SIV squad.
Woo! Cheers! Woo! Oh, I'm just so glad.
glad that we've saved little Buddy the Elf. Oh, I just got a text message from Santa, which is not easy with mittens. And he said Buddy the Elf's back at the North Pole. Oh, that life flight sure is quick.
Yeah, and our culprit, Billy B, he's already serving his sentence. I think he's going to learn his lesson this time.
Yeah, I saw him roaming the streets. He looks pretty tired. Probably the lack of caffeine to his brain cells.
When I saw him, he tried to steal my potato chips.
Maybe he'll never learn.
Well, the most important thing is that Christmas is saved indubitably.
And you know what we do when we solve a great case?
It's party!
Woo!
I came to dance, 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 dance. I hit the floor cause that's my plans, 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 plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands, 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 brands. Give me some space for both my hands, 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 hands. You, you, cause it goes on and on and on.
Case closed. Merry Christmas.
Was he good looking?
Oh, yeah, I forgot that part.
Yeah. Thank you.
We suffered.
Okay. Through the whole scene and then we'll do the close-up lines all together. Something wrong?
Nope.
Okay. You just filmed yourself. I noticed that blooper.
It's still filming.
Yeah.
Okay, did you call in reinforcements?
Yeah, I figured this could get ugly. You're messing up our scene!
Filming in progress. We're making a movie.
Jeez, dear.
Go ahead.
Calm down, Drew.
Oh, I didn't know what you meant.
Oh,
what's
okay.
Going on here?
Take two.
What? You gave him your perfect equation of bagel recipe? Of the bagel recipe?
Wait, you...
And I told him to go up to the trailing you because he said he was low on bloat.
That was so good.
Whoa.
He was
okay.
Bloated.
Okay, we're gonna start at three.
Oh, no.
No, two.
You're so good. Okay.
Yeah, and then
why don't
you do the...
Okay.
Go. Let's hope the jingle bell... Oh, wait. I started.
That's right, go ahead. Keep going. Set, go.
Let's hope the jingle bell...
I wanted to have a good blooper. Idea, Bond. Good idea, Bond. Really good idea. Good idea.
Good idea.
Is it a good idea, Margaret?
Yeah. I think it's a good idea.
Oh, your office is start all over.
Thank you.
You come out in a Coast Guard boat or on your own boat?
We live here.
Oh, okay.
Hi, Nellyn. Hi. Hi.
Well, that was a complete waste of time. What are we going to do now?
Well, before we head back to the
We're
stage...
We're filming a movie!
Vivo!
Hey, guys?
Yeah.
Okay, where I'm pointing, put a Sharpie, okay? Please.
Where?
Where I'm pointing, like right here.
When, can you just poke it a little harder? Good. Yeah, that's good.
Try and pop it now. I made sure that no scissors could penetrate it. Aha! I did the same trick.
You're supposed to be being tortured. It's not silent, Bart. Your part's not silent.
It is?
No.
What is inside of him? Good idea, Sputnik. Sputnik. Captain Mark.
Come back and do it one more time.
Great, Captain. It looks like... and it looks like... Christmas Buddy! Cookie Monster is only a puppet. You probably couldn't have done it.
Oh, God.
I did tape it.
Is this my travel slime?
Yeah.
And dissolving the genetic makeup of the... Genetics! I keep my hat now!
Casey!
Oh, it's a rat!
What? Ah, that's my hat! Ow!
That's a rat!
Probably started like breakdancing.
Hey, what's that?
Who? What kind of loser wears a green shoe?
A loser who happens to be our elf who happens to be missing.
Oh, right.
He's a hobo.
Hey, look here. Something has fallen off this part right here. And look here.
I fell off.
That's my line.
Oh. Sorry.
You say it looks-
oh, yeah. Yeah, where's my line?
Genius, dear Shrew. Now you're thinking.
Upton must be his. The one we found in the U.
Yeah.
Not the one we found
in the
post
office. Jesse. Yeah. Wait, the one we found in the post office?
What?
Yeah. Can you see my shadow? When you're...
I said, do you find anything?
No,
else?
No. No, I can't.
And then you say, we should.
Whoa. We should repeat. And then there's probably some music.
It's
a
shuffle.
Great time. Shuffling.
Wait, we're filming?
You're dancing.
They're just figuring it out.
Okay.
Sorry.
Come on, Mom.
I'm sorry. Yep.
Get the smiles out.
Yeah.
Okay. Ready?
Hey, Cheryl.
Yeah.
Quinn.
What?
For the elf napping of Buddy the Elf.
I am innocent, I swear.
We forgot my line.
Oh yeah, after he arrested
this moron, I'm gonna pass sentence right now. I sentence you to a year without potato chips, coffee, or your truck. And we will revisit this case next Christmas. Get started right now, get that away from me.
To do to crack him.
Okay, good, well you wanna have another, you can't fly on one wing.
Okay.
Okay, counselor, stay low and zigzag.
Thank you.
That's a wrap.